we started with a Poisson type of equation, that is, but then the solution that we obtained was a Laplacian, because right hand side we made it equal to 0 f equal to. And then I have also shown you how the solution is obtained normally by Gaussian elimination. Now, this is the most rudimentary approach on which most of the numerical techniques of solution of linear equations are based. Okay, this is the basis, but then there are so many other things, you know, advanced. So, that you have to read on your own. And I would only say that you please solve one problem on your own, because we have solved this. Let right hand side f x be not 0, it be 1 minus x square, f x equal to non-homogeneous. So, please solve the same problem, let it be, this is defined between x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, that means, L is equal to 1. Well, simplification you can do, you can also take k equal to 1, but then let 1 minus x square be there, because that will give you the effect of non-homogeneous term on the and the type of solution. There you got a linear solution, and you will immediately see the linear solution is, you will not get a linear solution now, and then there will be difference between. Also try to get analytical solution for this. This you, we have all learnt it several years ago, analytical solution. That means, phi will be as a function of x, complementary function plus particular integral, standard. So, this will be exact solution. Exact solution of the governing differential equation. There also, last time also by making this 0, we had solved exactly. And the solution was 1 minus x, linear solution. So, here again you please solve the exact solution. So, you will have a exact solution between, and let the boundary conditions be same. The boundary conditions at x equal to 0, let phi here be is equal to 1, and here phi b is equal to 0. So, at the both points boundary conditions are same. So, now it is only a question of variation in between. So, this is the domain. So, here it is 1 boundary condition, here it is 0. In between, obviously, it will not be zero linear now. It could be like this, it could be like this. So, please find out. So, you will have the exact solution. And divide this domain, that is 1, you take. Please take, get number of solution n equal to 5, nahi, n equal to, let us say 4, 8 and 16, just 3 solution, number of n, that means 1 by 1 will be, you know. So, try to see, and then you can yourself see. Then compare the result with exact. Also, see convergence, because I have given you 3. So, convergence, consistency, whether the solution, that means consistency means as h increases reduces, as h reduces, phi approximate, or shall I say phi I, approximate means subscript I, that will approach phi x I, because this one is exact and this one is approximate. So, that also you can see. So please look up these things and solve this problem. You can take help of whatever. Actually, I have already told this Book World Enterprise the books.
They have got.
They have got now.
Okay. Okay.
Because last week I told.
No, it is also there.
So. So this he said he will get it. So. Today, let us extend this idea to tackling two-dimensional problem. After all, you know, one dimensional only for classroom textbook for explaining, but real problems are also always two and three-dimensional, you know, real life problems. So, two-dimensional problem is a, so if you have a domain, this is the boundary. And this is the domain. So, two-dimensional problem we also call this as 2D, instead of 1D we call it 2D. Let us say this domain is governed by, or this is by the same similar type of, it is by this del square phi equal to f x y. This is non-homogeneous term now, and del square phi is there. So, del square phi, and introduce also some k here. Let coefficient be there, some thermal conductivity and things like that. So, which can be expanded as so, at any point inside, any point, this governing differential equation is satisfied. So, this is in domain, we always say this is valid in domain omega, and then on boundary we have some boundary condition. So, on boundary we will have phi prescribed or d phi by d n. Now, I cannot say d, see any derivative here, this is let us say n. So, it will have two components. So, normal d phi by d n means it is drawn on normal here at the boundary. This also, so either this is prescribed or this is prescribed and this is prescribed, or at phi itself is prescribed at, you know, 2 pi. So, these two are so, we will take a specialized problem. I do not know how many of you have come across, you know, when we study torsion problem in mechanics of solids, we take a circular cross section and then apply a torque and we study the geometry of deformation of the circular cross section first. And then in the process, we note so many, you know, so many physical happenings that happen, you know, in the, to the cross section. We find that the any radial line in the cross section turns by certain amount and it remains also straight, it does not. We also find that the cross section, if you take a cross section normal to the axis, this cross section after the torque is applied, there is a possibility of this cross section getting warped. Warped means out of axis, out of cross section deformation. It can warp, it can become something like that, but it does not happen because there is a consideration of symmetry that it can be proved. So, based upon all those, we find that the torsion problem is for the circular cross section becomes a simple problem, not a very complicated, and that is why we introduced that in the first course. But the moment you go to torsion of non-circular crossing, like a rectangular cross section, torsion of a rectangular cross section, elliptical, any non-circular, then the problem comes in. And in fact, torsion of circular, non-circular cross section is governed by an equation of this type. Phi is a function, torsion function that we call it, but then it is governed by a similar equation. So, plus there are many, as I told you. So, in addition to whatever we have learned, we will how to now go about it. First of all, now we have got two dimensions, not one, but two dimension. So, this is x and this is y. So, any point here P has got coordinate x and y. So, P can move along x, along y, or along any general direction in the plane of the paper. So, what we normally do, because after all, how will you locate a point P? Of course, this is a general cross section. So, we usually, if we take, if let us say this is your, supposing we take a rectangular domain, and these are the limits of the rectangular domain. So, what normally we will do, you see your cross section is something like this. I am not talking of a general cross section, because I am just trying to simplify the problem. This is x and y. So, this one is my domain, and it is bounded by four lines, two are parallel to x axis and another two are parallel to y axis, and the boundary conditions will be on these lines. These are the bounding lines. So, we will have some boundary conditions on this. So, I will take a problem and then try to formulate it for you. And so, this is a Poisson equation. In fact, this one is nothing but a Poisson equation. So, let us take that we are, the domain is rectangular and k is equal to 1. So, we have f x y, let me assume f x y function be a constant function 2 with a minus sign, just for, and the other boundary condition is that phi is 0 on boundary. So, this is your problem definition. This is in domain, rectangular domain. And rectangular domain is governed by, is given by this length is 3, this length is 2, a rectangle of 3 by 2, the equation is valid inside this, and on the boundary phi is 0. We have to solve this problem. So, what we have to do, you take any so, first of all, fix your origin coordinates. And now we have got two linear dimensions x and y. So, please 3. So, we will have n 1 and n 2 and n 2 along this, not single n, but you have n 1 and n 2. Let us say that the dimension x dimension is, which is L 1 and this one is L 2, is divided by. So, therefore, we get here delta x 1, sorry, delta x is L 1 by n 1, or here it is 3 by n 1, does not matter. Similarly, delta y equal to L 2 by n 2 or 2 by n 2. We normally keep delta x and delta y same for simplicity, otherwise life will become, you know, complicated and things will, and you are not getting anything extra out of complication, you know, because after all it is a numerical process. So, we keep delta x and delta y same. So, we'll always, you know, so delta x normally will be that means you adjust with your n. Of course, if it is not possible, that is a different matter, but then if it is same, then it is easier. No, no, that is the equation. That means f x, value of f x y is minus 2. Yes, it is given, not 2. It is non-homogeneous and it is given 2. Then so, now my point, let me divide my y dimension by, similarly x dimension by another set of. So, this one is delta x, and this one is delta y, all right, but then it is, we have now the point P, any general point P. So, I will just take this point P in the domain has coordinate P x y. So, let me call that, now let my abscissa x axis be denoted as x i minus 1 x I plus 1, that means this one, these 3, this is x I, this is x I minus 1, this is x I, such that delta x is equal to x I minus 1, or even I can go to like this, etcetera. This is okay now, ith point, see. So, let me say now this point is P, general x y. Now, I am saying I am fixing the point. So, I am now calling it P x I y j. Now, I will have to use in general two subscripts, not only one. Because in general, j can vary differently, you know. I told you only for practical problem we keep delta x equal to delta y, but there is no restriction. So this is so point P is, so I have to do this. So here again this one is call it as y I, this point is sorry y j minus 1 and y j plus 1, such that this point is P, or you can also call this finally, because we do not write this x I the moment, this is the exact value point if you are locating. I can write it P I j, they all mean the same thing. But the meaning, the moment we put only subscript means it is a approximate location. Up to here it is okay, it is, we are really defining the point in actual, but then here the moment you put this means there is some difference between P I j and P x I y j, because this one is the actual location of point and this one you know is the approximate that we will get out of. So, this is how we interpret. Any subscript like this is always we approximate, and up to here it is. Of course, this is general point, so this is only we are fixing the point P. So, why? Now, how to, yes, we have got second derivative of phi with respect to x square. So, how to express this? We are here, I want to find out, that means this one I want to find out at x I y j. What is the value of this at x I, first derivative, because I will have to write down the total del square phi at, I have to define here at any point, my point is P I j. So, I am now writing one of the two, this equal to this. This you can also write, this is partial, many people write it as I j will come, but they also write first like this, I also, and then many places you will find also a comma in between, and then comma is also you know forgotten, and we simply write this as del square phi i j, yes, at i j, at point I j means P I j at x I x j, what is the approximate value of the second derivative there. So, how to do this? Yes. So, we are here and this is the partial derivative with respect to x. So, that means keeping y constant, that means our movement is only along x, and we know this from our past this one, you know how to. Here this is a partial derivative with respect to x, that means we are here this point, and I have to move with respect to x means I have to move only along this. So, it will need the second derivative at this point, I know how to express in terms of three values. So, this can be expressed as phi, therefore, I j, now this is everything is approximate, no operation. So, I can express this as phi, phi what? Phi at value, we are moving this way. So, x I minus 1 y j minus 2 phi x I y j plus phi. Now, here is, here you see this value is what? X I minus 1 y j, this one is x I y j, and this one will become x I plus 1 y j, x I plus 1, x I plus 1 y j. Three quantities it will need by delta x square, and of course, the error is of order delta x square. So, that is why I have written here. So, this, if it is like this, then I can get an approximation of this by, I can simply write I minus 1. Now, I will have to use a comma, otherwise there will be problem. I minus 1, this value, approximate value of this, like this, minus 2 times phi I j plus phi I plus 1 j. Now, I am forgetting about the error term. And that is why, because I am forgetting about the error truncation. So, this is the truncation error, this is truncation error.
So, little,
little, yes, truncation error. Because all the terms up to infinity, they are being truncated there. So, that will lead to some error, that is why we have put here. So, second derivative is found out approximately by this simple formula, and in the same way, similarly, del square phi del y square at the same point I j can be approximated. That means, now I will have to, if I want to find out at the same point the second derivative with respect to y, keeping x constant means at x I, I will have to move this way. So, this point, these are the three points here. Similarly, these are the three points there. So, this one will be phi. I should not make mistake. So, what is the value of this? This is phi I j minus 1, I j minus 1. So, it will change. So, it is I j minus 1 minus twice phi I j plus phi I. I is x. So, that is not changing. X is not changing, only j is changing. So, j plus 1. So, we have got. So, now, delta y. So, now we know how to express the partial derivatives in x and second partial derivatives in x and y, and in terms of nodal values. These are all nodal values, derivatives have been replaced by nodal values. So, this is called, this is what is called finite difference. We are using finite difference approximation to express the, because in the limit as delta x and delta y tend to 0, this becomes, definition comes out to be the actual derivative. But now, we are going back. We are going to the basic definition, and we are keeping this finite value. So, it will be approximate. So, we have got this. So, let me, so now therefore, therefore this phi ij, what will be this equal to? So if you see here, this will be, in fact it consists of 5 points. It consists of, it will need any, at any value ij, we will need 5 points to define del square phi ij. 2 on x axis either side and 2 point on, and the central point. So it will be always phi I minus 1 j, then plus phi I j minus 1 minus 4 times, because this is common, this is 4 times, and let us assume delta x and delta y are same. So 4 times phi I j plus phi I. Initially writing of I j could be little troublesome, but then once you understand what you are doing, and delta x, delta y, assume that they are same. So what should be right? I will say h, so that there is no confusion, you know, h is square. So h is delta x equal to delta y. So this is your numerical model, numerical formula for transforming this Laplacian del square phi into the nodal values. So if we have, now the problem is not that difficult. So let us say we are talking of a rectangular domain. And I have taken 2 by 3, this length is 2, this is 3. So I am dividing in such a way that both sides, so 3, so this is, all these divisions are 1.
But in this case, delta x will not be different.
Yes, it is, because this length is 2, this length is 3, so I am making them equal. This total length along x of my domain is 3 units. Total length along y is 2 units. So I am dividing in such a way, I am dividing by different ends, so that I get square. So all my cells are, these are cells. So you see here, this is a simple problem with boundary. So we have here how many points? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 12 points. There are 12 points, please note, 12 nodes in the process we have got. But out of these 12 nodes, 10 are on the boundary and only 2 are interior nodes. Only 2 are interior nodes. So that means your differential equation has to be written only at 2 points, not on the boundary. So we can write. So if your problem is, because it was given as del square phi equal to minus 2 and phi equal to, boundary condition is phi is 0 on this. This is your problem. Actually, this is a simple torsion problem, torsion of a rectangular cross section. Okay, so what normally is done, because ij is all right, but then we number the nodes, because unless we number, our life will not be easier. So, we number the nodes. Of course, here because I have to explain to you, I will number it in such a way that my first two numbers are the unknown nodes. See, here all these nodal values have phi equal to 0, because on the boundary everything phi is 0. So, that means this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, all the nodal values are 0, is it not? On the complete boundary phi is 0, but here, so let me say here, this node be 1, this node be, and then I number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I number like this. So, let me write down phi. So, what is del square phi at 1, node 1? It will be what? 4 times, I should not write, 1 times this, 1 times this, 1 times this, 1 times this, minus 4 times of this. So, minus 4 times of this is, I am just taking, see, 1 times of this means this is 0 already, phi 4 is 0. I will write it here for you, all phi is, that means phi 3 to 12 except 3 to 12 because we have taken 1 2 anyway, so 3 to 12 are 0. So this will be equal to, this is 0, then this one is, so phi 2. So now subscript reduces from ij, it reduces only one digit. This is one good thing. By numbering the node, you are dealing only with 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, not 1, 2. So don't make the mistake of numbering the nodes by 1, 2. You will be land yourself in difficulty. Always number by single digit, whether it is one dimensional problem or two dimensional or three dimensional. Node is a node by a simple number, So, phi 2, then phi 6 is 0, phi 7 is 0. So, this minus 4 phi 1, that is all. That is all, equal to this. Then what about this? Del square. This is equal to so we are writing, sorry. So we have written this completely at this point. Del square, complete del square, yes, because we wrote del square. It is del, x and y both are included. So I don't have to worry. So, this is at 1 I have completed, and this is equal to what? Minus 2. At this point it is minus 2. So, similarly, you please find out del square phi at 2. So, that will be only phi 1 minus 4 phi 2 equal to minus 2. So, we have got two equations with two unknowns. Boundary conditions already we have put, otherwise we would have written a long equation here with so many, and then put this. So, that means boundary conditions are already here put, included. So, we have got finally two algebraic equations, therefore, this is equivalent to So, if you write down in terms of phi 1 and phi 2, so A matrix will be minus, let me multiply by, so it will be 4 minus 1 times, yes, 4 minus 1, phi 1, phi 2, and this let it be like this only, 4 minus 1, right hand side will be 2. So, 4 phi 1 minus phi 2 equal to 2, okay. Now, phi 1, so I will have 1 minus 4, I should make it minus 1 here and plus 4 equal to again 2. Of course, both will be same. The problem will, I mean the way it is there, phi 1 must be equal to phi 2, but it will come out of these two solutions. So, you can solve this two system of equation and what is the value of phi 1, phi 2? What will be the value of phi 1 and phi 2? Four. So, if I multiply by 4, multiply second equation by 4 and add the 2. So, you will get only phi 2. So, 4 second equation, that means 16 minus 1. See, if I multiply the second equation by 4, so how much? Phi 1 equal to phi 2 equal to 2 by 5? 2 by 3, 100%? I do not want to, okay. 2 by 3? Okay. Checked. All right. So, we got this. So, this is how, I mean this is a simple problem with two unknowns, just two unknowns. So, we got it. But if the problem is there with 100 unknowns, then you will have to be careful and you will have to, but problem formulation is more important. So, we can solve such problems without any difficulty, and in all this you see now, whether it is a one dimensional problem or two dimensional problem, we found that differential equation, always remember this, any numerical procedure always transforms the differential equation system, DE system, differential equation system into algebraic equation system. Differential equation means this del square phi k minus 2 was, has been transformed into A times into x equal to b. And so, equation solution is a very, very important. So, if you see the history, see after computers came, people started solving bigger problems with more number of unknowns. Earlier, see, we know in our school we solve three unknown, you know, three, x 1, x 2, x 3, not 4. 4 becomes too tedious, you know, 4 unknowns, up to 3, yes, we can solve. That also is quite lengthy, you know. So, when computers, digital computers, so if you find, you know, came and people started bigger and bigger problems, so this size is started becoming larger, size of the matrix, size of the matrix A, size of the matrix B. A means every coefficient has to be put in the memory of the computer. So, memory of the computer also was limited in those days, you know, it was very, very limited. So, people have developed, they spent lot of time how to solve this equation with a small computer, but having a very large matrix. so that you don't have to put all the coefficients of A into the memory at a time. Keep something outside, only keep those quantities, those A part that are required for the computation, and then so lot of research, lot of people have done, but now of course those are all history. So that is solution of equation itself, how to solve very large system of equations of various types, where the main thrust of work in those days. Okay, but then this finite difference, for unfortunately after the computers came in 60s, finite difference was already a established procedure. Finite difference already was there, FDM, you know, the first book on by Scarborough, I will show you, there is one book by Scarborough, was written sometime in 1927 or so on finite difference, numerical analysis using finite difference, you know. But then it had remained only a, you know, tabletop book, and not many practical problems could be solved, but the concept was already there. But the time when computers came in 60, in the early 60s, there is another method that came, that is finite element. Around that time it was invented. So most of the solution of equations research that was done was not concerning, because by that time people were not interested in finite difference. It was established, it is a very simple procedure. It can always be formulated, you can formulate and solve, but the new method that was there, that finite element, that was more challenging. So most of the work was done in relation to finite element. So I will of course discuss that also, but little later. So this is the history of numerical methods. Okay, so this is I have given you here. Now so far I have taken the boundary condition in both these problems, 1 and 2 dimension, it is called Dirichlet type of boundary condition, phi is prescribed. Now, when you have Newman type of boundary condition prescribed, that means derivative is prescribed, then what happens? Just if anybody can, this is spelling I am not very confident, Newman, any W or MA, anyway, Newman type of boundary condition. So anyway, I will correct it, you can also see. So this, unfortunately it is being recorded, does not matter, you know, the mistake will be, the spelling mistake will be there on the, does not matter. So this is Newman type of boundary condition. So if you have the boundary condition, that means d phi by dx, d phi by dy prescribed, or in one dimension d phi by dx prescribed. In that case, see the, I will take one dimension first. Let us say this is my domain. This is my domain with so many nodes, interior nodes, 3 interior nodes and 2 boundary nodes. 3 interior and 2 boundary nodes. And what is given is that here it is given phi, that phi is equal to 1, and here it is given that d phi by dx is equal to 0, slope is, this is prescribed.
What
is that?
You can have second derivative boundary first
Yes, yes. No, no, I think this I have been telling you, no. One derivative less.
In case of beam equation.
No, no, beam. I am not talking of beam. First of all, I am taking only second order differential equation, not fourth order differential equation. So, beam will take later. First concentrate on second order differential equation. So, highest derivative that occur in the differential equation, you can prescribe only one derivative less than that, okay. Never that derivative, because that is differential equation. Beam will take later. Yes, there also, yes. Derivative type boundary condition. But this is the basic Newman type, you know, you cannot have lower than d phi by dx. So, yes, second derivative, third derivative also will be the Newman type. So, if it is given, then how to deal with the problem? In that case, see, because then the phi here, this is a boundary node, all right, but boundary node phi is unknown. Slope is prescribed, but phi is unknown. So, that means this node will be an unknown node.
For which the equation
will be? Yes. So, I mean, because how to otherwise, how to find out, you know. So, this. So, value of phi has to be found out for this. See, this is interior, all right, but then here, and then the problem also comes, of course, time is, I think your time is just, I think 4-5 minutes are there, but does not matter, I will leave you after 1 minute. Then the problem comes, how to prescribe the derivative. Now, there are two. Supposing you are here, you can say I will use backward difference to prescribe the, that means this quantity minus this quantity equal to the derivative. That is, but you know in backward difference, this error is large. We would not like to, because large error, you know. So we'll suppose you want to now, no, I will use central difference. Then in that case, we introduce fictitious node outside to define this as a you know. By central difference formula. In that case, what happens? Now, this becomes your extended boundary, then this becomes an interior node. So, these are things that we will discuss next time. Okay. So, we will take one problem and with reference to that. So, similarly here, if it is here derivative, then we cannot use here backward, you will have to use forward difference formula, but the same. So, like this, the derivative boundary conditions are dealt with. Okay, many